Look, the question that y'all say a lot is beta, right? We keep saying beta, beta. So the question I have for Mike, and then we'll get into Saul and his thoughts and stuff, is that, like, do we consider this a beta? Is this, because a lot of people was like, hey, you can't review this. You know, it shouldn't be reviewed because technically it's a beta. Do we think it is fair to put this criticism on it yet? Or it's like, hey, you charge money, you get the smoke, you know, kind of thing. So where are you at with that, Mike? Like, when the whole beta controversy, because you can't criticize it or you can't criticize it.
You know, that's a tough one there, Cog, when you talk about beta and where we're at today and you look at other betas that have dropped, right? But truly and honestly, I do expect them to open up a little bit when we get to December 8th with playlists, right? Yeah, they have announced that this is the full maps, right? These are 10 maps that you're going to get. So I don't expect brand new maps on December 8th, whether I want them or not, right? But I do expect a little bit of opening when it comes down to playlists and stuff.
Yeah.
But should I be able to give them back some constructive criticism and have a conversation or even review it like IGN has? Yeah, totally. I think this is going to be very close to your full product that you're going to get when they announce that it's not a beta, right, on December 8th, if that's what's up. So I think you're getting very close to what they expect you to get. Okay. So, yeah, for me, no, I think it's all – I think they need the feedback, too. This team knows – that they wanted to change it up, and there's a lot of feedback out there,
no doubt.
And that's the reason I'm so vocal, Snowbike, is like, this is the most fun I've had in a multiplayer a Halo game in years, and I want this game to come out there next holiday. It's SmackDown, Warzone, and Fortnite. So like, in the survival of this game, it does have to compete with the other free to play games. So it's like, if you don't like, they're trying to do what Fortnite does. The exact thing almost, because this is about what Fortnite does. But the problem is Fortnite has a lot more reach that Halo can't realistically get. For Halo can't do a live concert. I would hope they wouldn't do that. Like, so like they don't have that reach to the casual market that Halo does. So Halo's got to do stuff differently than Fortnite does.
Right. No, we get that. Yeah. We get that. I got to get solvent. What are your thoughts, man, about, you know, just the multiplayer, you know, the good, obviously, how you feeling about it, and then obviously the controversy in reference to the progression and the live event.
Y'all all just a bunch of crackheads. y'all really can't help yourselves. Y'all really can't. Y'all can't. I saw this from the beginning, right? And I'm just like, no, I'm here to play Halo. I don't care.
You here to be ashy?
Dip me in ash. I don't care. That make me look like I'm running around dipped in concrete. I don't care. Until I do.
Until they make something that you like.
But when it comes, like, balancing a free to play game is no easy task, right? So be prepared.
They've done
to be
a really good job coming out the gate too.
Right, right. So, but just remember,
besides the spike gun, that needs to get nerfed. There's no reason you should do one hit to kill anything.
This is a conversation that's going to be happening for years because they're just going to keep tweaking and balancing, right? So you're going to go through your ups and downs like you guys go through with Destiny, where you hate it for a little while, you love it for a little while. This is the cadence. This is what it is, right? So I can understand everybody's beef, particularly what I see with the Battle Pass now, right? What I see, like, I play a match, whatever, and I get my little 50 at the end, and I'm like, wow, and I'm at zero, and you see the long line to get to the one. I'm like, oh, man. Now, the thing is, at my core, I don't care about that, right? I really don't care about it. It's just funny to see, right? So one thing that Adam Attic mentioned that is very true that I do believe, because now they are playing in this space, right? It's imperative that they fix this sooner rather than later.
Yes.
Because despite me just being there for Halo and that part of Halo being great, right? If they don't fix this, then at the end of the day, what you're going to have is just hardcore Halo guys playing this game. And it's not going to have the reach you intended for it to have as a free-to-play game.
Right.
Because a lot of the younger players, the players that are used to playing the Fortnites, the Warzones, Fortnite has had years to figure this out, right? Warzone also has had time to figure this out.
Right.
If they don't figure this out quickly, gamers are fickle.
Yeah.
They're gonna walk away from
the
it.
Thing,
they will.
The thing,
except the hardcore.
Yeah.
The thing is, like, when it comes to, like, the progression, they need to find a better way of rewarding, you know, people that play above average. They need to find a better way of rewarding cosmetics to certain people. So I said, like, imply the Master Chief Collection to right. do certain things, to get certain things over on Infinite. I think that would be good. Like, all I need to see is people like Dr. Disrespect talk all that in sense. And then when that game come out, he dropped all of that. And you could see the genuine joy in him playing the right. game. So, like, you can talk all you want, but when you play those sticks and you play that game, all that's out the window.
And that's the thing, right? The game is there. So yeah. it would be yeah. sad. It would be sad if people walk away from it just because this part I isn't this working is
a
for
whole
them.
Bunch of hubbub for nothing.
Go ahead, Kay.
I think oh, on December 8th, when the game actually launches, everything will be transformed. I think.
Oh, so you think it's a major change? What happened December 8th?
Bethany's coming up. What do you think's transforming between now and the 8th?
That's what I would like okay. to know.
I believe that the single player is going to give you a lot of that XP that you're looking for.
I agree.
I agree with that.
If you look in the challenges, if you look in the challenges, you see a lot of incidences where it says end PvP. Yeah. So there's a they're yeah. designated PvP oh. for a reason because yeah. there's going to be PvP.
I agree with King on that part. Exactly. I do.
Yeah. So I believe that stuff is tied there. Mm. So I believe everybody is have this fake outrage, but still out there blazing fake it outrage. To their knuckle feet. You know,
can't be legit. White, fake.
They because it's fake.
Why is it's fake? White knuckling. They're white knuckling.
Because they don't want to spend the $44.50.
So they have to pay $44.50 to enjoy this game.
You know, and the whole thing is, then suffer and grind. that's it. Suffer and grind, or pay your $44 and get up there. Right?
So just to clarify,
you pay your $44 and they're still asking you to grind for
something. Yeah, you can't get the ninja sword you want until you grind.
Just to clarify.
You're just looking pretty grinding, but it's the same thing.
Hold up. King, just to clarify, I got to hear it come from your mouth.
Say it.
You agree that people should only get 50 experience, regardless if they win or lose. Yeah. That's acceptable.
That's good with kids.
I don't care about their pain. like you see, what you wilding out about is I'm doing the challenge. I learned my lesson.
You know what's funny?
I got my ninja suit the same day.
This is the same person that said. So
I got my ninja suit.
You know what's about to happen here. I have a crystal ball. I can see the future. At one point in time, I don't know if it's going to happen this episode. Maybe in the future, King's going to say, "Well, Addict, I've saved so much money from Game Pass, I can afford to give Halo Infinite my money."
No. It's not even that. It's about me being a hypocrite. Right? So,
let's acknowledge this.
Shout out to me. That's right. Shout out to me identifying me. All right? So I sat here and I went in on all you dudes about that beta boy.
Yes, and you out here.
And I said, when it's my thing, I'm going to do
it. Full effect beta boy.
Listen.
And microtransactions in the beta. You outside.
Wait a second. Yeah. I never said I wasn't about micro. I don't care about that. When people was out there talk about, I don't like microtransactions. That's your wallet talking. I don't have that problem. Like, I think loot boxes should be out of I don't care about that. I'm going to pay every is that?
It's a corporation's dream.
This is what we have to clarify now.
Yes. King, just remember, anytime anything like this comes up,
they're gonna say
we know that if it gives you an unfair advantage,
that's right.
King is there.
Normally
we be in Breath of the Wild. Yes. Like, why would you cheat in Breath of the Wild?
Normally we behave with guests, but today's not that day.
We gotta let Mike get his balls off because Mike wanted to jump in. We interrupt.
Well,
Mike.
I mean, we've been having fun and talking about it. We haven't even talked about the new event and the battle pass right?
Yes.
And we look at
that's another 30
levels,
beast.
And there's a whole nother beast. But here's one for y'all that maybe you didn't see, right?
Let's go.
If you look at the battle pass near and close, there's 16, whether it be missions or challenge swaps and XP boosts. That's half of your battle pass is not even any sort of cool cosmetics, right? Then when you break it down past that, five of those are just weapon stickers.
Yes.
And get this, there's not a single cool samurai armor skin in that.
When we look at that, it's like that content
is not there.
Thank you.
Right? If you're going to give us the cool samurai armor, I love that. but at least give me some cool skins before I have to go drop $20. I'll drop money if I want to look cool.
What they have to figure out about the free-to-play thing is that, and I don't play these games, but
what they
got to
figure out is what they can get away with. That's what they got to figure out. Yeah, but the thing is,
they'll do that eventually, trust me. But up front, see, when you drop these games, right, up front, you have to make the player feel.
That was very corporate takeover. Salute to Attic on that one. He said, so we got to figure out what we can get away with.
Exactly.